give this another go then. My GoPro is running low on battery, so I'm not sure how much I'll get, but it's good either way. Gonna avoid this snow. Legs are pretty knackered just off the ascent there, up from the A82 all the way down there, pretty much where that long scree slope leading down from the end of Ascent, I forget the name of the top of the end, Munro. Fair bit of ascent, see a few tops around there in the distance, are covered by clouds. It'll be alright over here. Okay. Just getting towards the start of number one buttress proper. Arch gully, even leading up on the side there. Down route. Kind of steadily following the gully just to the left, so I think that's east. I'll double check just so. Yeah, east. East, north behind me, so. Yeah. Just double check the general. Yeah, we want to be generally south southwest. It'll keep me on the main direction of the route, I think. honest. It doesn't quite look as nice as I would wish it did. Used to this extra couple of inches of hair I've got with the helmet on. Did that sound bad? No. I think using inches and head in some sentences. A little bit risky. In the kind of wrong way for comfort, but good solid holds by the same. I don't know, I mean this feels a lot worse than being stood on the edge of Tower Gap yesterday. It's just a case of making sure that the rock is good to hold and stand on, and beyond that, it's just a sort of mixture of confidence and common sense. It's a very wet looking dike. So my belief is that we follow the dike up now, so we've got the sheet of paper. I copied it out of the book. I've got the book on me, but 5 meters left for Glencoe and send orange rocks saying we hold Angolesas. On the start of the Buttress proper. Find the wall midway. Midway between the artillery. Continue up these slabs, trending left. To reach the right side of the chimney, that's where we are now. Scrambled easily up beside this superb rock. Interspersed with small moss ledges. Large scree terrace nest stuck. Kidding, it's a wonderful rock to climb. A decent pair of shoes on. It's there's just no shortage of good holds, and the rock itself is pretty stable. Most ledges. As much as possible because my legs are a bit shot off yesterday. expecting the rock to just disappear below my feet sometimes, where it's cracked, but I'll speak too soon, but hasn't really given way yet. It's just all this muddy crap. That doesn't feel too nice. The hardest stuff's nearer the top. A couple of bits. One bit where the book advises that route finding is pretty paramount. And another part where it says that retreat would be difficult. I mean, that's gonna be. So I don't know really. None of that looks too bad to me, but it's a different story when you get up. And the terrace still there, scattered with snow and debris. Let's see what it wants me to do. Moves away from the dike now. I know there's no one below me, but after yesterday I want to be a bit more quick to warn of any rockfall. You never know how quickly someone might have got up behind you. Yeah, so I'm being advised that I've got some careful route finding, which kind of makes sense. I mean, some of these slabs are pretty severe. Some people on the summit there. Right on the top. It's an even nicer day than yesterday in a Pigo. So, I'm quite halfway between our arch gully and the dike. Really specific, this thing, so it's like it's giving you this sense that if you don't find the exact jug hold that it wants you to find, then you're fucked. But I don't know, maybe it's just trying to direct you to one of the good routes up it. I'm sure it doesn't all just depend on one single jug hold, but then again, the crux of Tower Ridge really does depend on one single foothold to make the difference between being really, really quite inexcusably risky without a rope and being comfortably doable. Rusty recess left at first, then basically, I just want to get past the easier ground. So I'm told that it's more vegetated up there. You want to just be heading. I'll give it a go anyway, it's not going to be. campground on left, Slogan route on right, terrace just above, so I'm just gonna power up and deviate away from the 3S and end up saying, oh, I've done this nice, interesting 3S, when actually all I've done is something a bit easier than that. Serve you well on this kind of thing. A bit of rainfall and this would be quite a different story. rock seems quite absorbent. So it's not going to be the slippiest, but just a little moss patches in between it. I can imagine it getting pretty slimy. Beeps on my GoPro, unless it's so low on battery that it doesn't even beep. Hello? Even then, I didn't expect it to work. End up all the way down there. I'm fairly sure no one else is on here. I want to go there, but I think it's straightforward to get along to. Shoulder here. After I did my GoPro video on Tower Ridge yesterday, I slipped over, tripped rather. It's good. Tripped. It's gonna be a bit of a ridge. Tripped over on Northeast Buttress. It's at the very top of it. I wasn't climbing it, but I accidentally ended up in it. So, tripped over and fell. It was a bit like falling forwards down some stairs. There was a bit of a gap between me and the next bit of rock. And I pulled the hand out so that my head flung a different way from the rock that it was approaching, since I wasn't even wearing my helmet anymore. And then basically collapsed sideways and the first thing that hit. First thing that hit anything was my hip. I don't know if you can see it, but got a very funny set of red and purple and some really nasty bruise. I was almost numb yesterday. Certainly not when I hit it, but I flew. continue up through a series of rocky steps, right, just level to it. Easy ground on left, steep ground on right. Head up towards steep rock. Prominent jutting stone. Well, I can see a prominent jutting stone. I've never noticed the right one. If you reach narrow ramp. Up leftwards immediately below the small roof formed by the jutting block. After that is a sustained and difficult to retreat section. Side of the gully and just be sensible with fruit landing. Should be alright. Oh god, not scary, but walks up this steep grass are probably a lot more tiring. View. It's nice to find at least one exposed rock to just perch upon. Again, pretty much all the rock up here so far has been quite fantastic. The only things that have moved have been the stuff that's lying on top anyway. I don't want to promise it, but I think anyone climbing up here would have to agree it's very satisfyingly reliable. Is an overhanging look, but I don't know, it's not had such a big block that I trusted to be a permanent feature of the mountain. Like I've almost finished climbing it yet. I mean that must be the jump now behind the rock. But I would really like to stick to this route the best I can, but how hard it would be to retreat, but I'll take their word for it. I'm also never sure if they're presuming that you're roping up, then it could well be that there's that roping up the roped descent backwards would be harder to retreat than too much overhang or that really. Climb like that, so the jutting block, hasn't it? Prominent and overhanging. Scratched my GoPro a bit yesterday, banging my head off stuff. Leftwards. Probably past this. Another small riff. Quite a big riff when it's sat right above you. So next we've got a sustained bit. Move up the ramp with difficulty. Reach small recess. Step left again and move up into the tapering mossy niche. Okay, I'm just gonna move up the ramp. Recess, mossy niche, right after the niche, exposed, move, round the slight bulge, traverse to a grassy ledge and take a breather. I'm under strict instructions to take a breather. Doesn't it look, you got look absolutely fantastic at this perspective and profile. I want to take some photos, but on the off chance that through all of that, this is where we get the shitty holds. That's alright. Yeah. up here. Retreat now. I'm just checking what it looks like. Lest I need to any emergency. It doesn't look like much, but right. It's just how it may as well be a fucking cliff face, you know. It's so I'm just where I last started. I just sat down. I'm drinking water. I'm a bit of a ponder over thoughts to myself, and waiting for my camera to get a bit more charge on it. Hopefully, and we'll see it through to the end of the route, which must be not too far away now. It's a bit unlucky that the camera broke at the most exposed bit of the route so far. If you look, I've got this chimney below us, and I don't think anyone falling down that would walk away from it. That's actually, I wish I'd never said that now, because whilst it's still there, it leaves the empathy of me being able to feel quite prominently what it might feel like. Just recap the route from here and steadily head up. Flimsy bits of paper. Okay, move the ramp, difficulty, step left again, move. Take room, mossy niche. Step right, move to the ramp. I think this is the grassy ledge. I think that was the main bit just there. Right. Move up by a small perched flake. Obvious weakness, and follow up to the top. I think from here there's just some nice roots. Just set myself away. Quite a few people walking the ridge there. It was nice. How nice the little bits of rock are. Not to understate the severity of it, but if you enjoy, as I do, challenging higher level scrambling and bouldering and stuff like that, this is like a playground up here. It's just challenging enough to stop you feeling like you can just go wherever you want and do whatever you like, but certainly got some satisfaction to just finding the route. So I'm pulling, giving good committing pulls up these jug kind of like holds. A bit more reach. There's a just to the other side of the face over there. It's probably well obscured by this ridge. Maybe it's just over finishing up over there. Maybe. Actually, no. This is just a arch gully, so way over there. I really want to give a go, but I don't know if my legs are gonna forgive me for that one. Yeah. sure that it will avoid any sense of complacency once I get to the top, lest I trip and fall over again. Could do without another bruise like that. First sun I've seen for a while there. I'm here on the top. So I gather it's a pretty straightforward case of scrambling up here now. A bit of height up to 1,107 metres of the summit of Billion the Man being up there. But it's nice to see that it looks like those huge pinnacles are easily accessed from the top there. A bit of down climbing and being careful. Here and see if I can really grab the rest of this on video, considering I arrived at the bottom with no GoPro power. Pretty happy. Jesus. Just being careful not to cause a huge rock fall here. Don't think it's steep enough to really do that much. Seen anyone else coming up? Feeling it now. What a great way. This little massive people on the summit there. I don't think I'll be able to see my arms moving set against this background. Shoot myself in the foot and head off up some Beith or something. Not Beith, but stick to this for a moment. See what it takes off. mud. It's covered in broken weathered rock. Some probably unnecessary traverses here. Just, like I said, it actually still is much easier on the legs to just do stuff like this. Something about the rock up here where I kind of don't want it to end so much, but I'll be happy to get to the top. A bit sad to leave this kind of scrambling and just have a steady uphill march to the I'll double check on the map, but maybe I'm looking at the right place. But that there is actually a nip from the sling on the I'll go and use it for climb, but I hung my bag off it and as it pulled around, it sort of caught my arm, which was resting next to it, and just nipped the skin very tightly and hit the rock. Can't really gauge how long that's taking me. I didn't check the time before I set off. Buttress, but since I'm up here, sit down, have some lunch, lie in the sun for half an hour, charge my GoPro, and head back up. If possible. I don't know if my legs are going to get me all the way up. You know, here, Gak. Monroe and along the ridge. I might not. adequately. Ridges and pinnacles and all these huge extruding buttresses. It's just fantastic shape. so much to do. It would be nice if while I was up here I could tap onto every single finger and pinnacle and so on that's accessible. See if there's any little mini scrambles to the tops of any interesting stuff. My first diff, 3S/diff, solo 3 ascent yesterday, and my first unseen ascent or something like this today. Really bad going. I'm not feeling ashamed of myself and not having more done by now. Record, I'm guessing number one, Buttress, proper finished quite far back there. I think this converges with the other ones, maybe coming from that way. To just give you the general walk to the summit. I don't know where the actual walking route is now. It's quite a large bit of ascent to walk up without doing the climbing I've just done, so I've no idea which way walk has come. Is that it? Can't figure out if that's still this is this top. In any case, the ridge done. I don't think there's that much to see of it from this angle. But well worth a look. Okay, if I spend them somewhere, it must be this huge black thing just imposing. CMD Arete Valley, north face on that side, pony tracker at the back, and Kemlon Beg on the right. That's about 30 miles away. That must be it. Jesus, what a fucking fantastic view. I know I'm not at the top yet, but I can see everything. There's an island out at sea there. I don't know what it is. Just, yeah, if you're used to seeing the lakes, it looks impressive, but this is like a step up. I know it's not the Alps, but a series, you know, as far as the eye can see, in some directions, right into the haze, and just got nothing but really quite high peaks. Scraping up pretty much every single one of them, looking like they've got some significant knife edge on them. So, yeah, thanking anyone in advance for watching this, it gives us a bit of comfort while I'm doing it. So yeah, that's number one Buttress done, and maybe I'll get a video of number three if I get it done this week. It's cloudy, but I wouldn't mind a shower. Thanks for watching, and yeah, come up here, have a safe time, and just be careful and enjoy the rock, it's absolutely brilliant. And take a video and then drop it in the comments. I'll be happy to know how your climbs went. It'll give me a lot of satisfaction to think anyone have watched it and gone up and enjoyed the day. So. Or if you think I did anything wrong or have any feedback.